Hello children, it feels good to meet you all once again. Hope you all are hale and hearty. Today's session is going to be very interesting. You know why? Because throughout the session you are going to spot two new words. It can come anytime, in the beginning, in the middle, in the end. What you have to do is just keep your eyes wide open to spot those words. Isn't it an interesting way to increase your vocabulary? So let's get started with today's session. Before we begin with today's session, I hope you all have started working on your English portfolio. If not, I would urge you all to start making or creating your English portfolio, because that will serve as a testimony of your creativity, skills and talents. What? Did you hear a new word? Yeah? What is it? Testimony. Yes, you're correct. Your new word for today is testimony. So, please check out the meaning for this word from your dictionary and find out why I am insisting you all to make your own portfolio. So today we are going to see the last two stanzas of the poem Past, Present, Future by Emily Bronte, and using the strategy called Isn't this picture looking beautiful? I know, this is not the one that is there in your text. You can consider it as a refurbished version of the picture that is there in the text. Wait, have you come across a new word? Yes, what is it? Refurbish. Yes, you are absolutely correct. So, take out your dictionary and check the meaning of this word. So, let's come back to our image, to our picture.
This picture is connected to the second stanza. Is it because this green environment, these green leaves, flowers gives us refreshing and energetic feeling and recharges us? And what about these birds? Is it because birds are known for their constant working of gathering food and making nest so that they do not suffer in the future? So let's find out from the second stanza whether our prediction is correct or not.
Stanza 2. Tell me, what is the present hour? A green and flowery spray, where a young bird sits gathering its spark to mount and fly away. So again in this stanza, the poet is asking the child, what is the present hour? And child has used metaphor to give the response, saying, for the child, present hour is like a green and flowery spray. Means the child is comparing its present hour with the green and flowery spray. The way we feel refreshing, energetic, looking at the green environment, same way for the child, present hour is pleasant one, refreshing one, encourages this child to do something new. And if you look at the next line, where a young bird sits gathering its spark to mount and fly away, so here the child is indirectly comparing himself with the young bird. The way young bird never stop working, same way the child using his or her present hour to enhance his or her skills without stopping, so that it will be helpful for the child in future. So here is a small task to know, how are we using our present hour? So the task is, how are you utilizing your present hour so that it benefits your future? You can give your response either in a written form, that means in a paragraph, or even in a points, or you can draw and tell. That means you can draw as to what you are doing in your present hour. And all this thing you are going to note it down in your English portfolio. Let's move ahead to the next stanza. On this slide you can find image towards your left and two questions towards your right. So first we are going to observe the image carefully and then look at the questions and try to answer them. So here in this image you will find a big question mark. Then there is a sky as birds are flying, as boat is sailing, so we can see the sea as well. So what do you think? How this image is relevant to our last stanza? Okay, let's see the question. Do you think this question mark has any relation with one of the period? Which period it can be?
and how is it related?
Okay, tell me, when do we use question mark?
Yes, exactly. We use question mark when we are unaware of something.
Yes? So which time period it could be?
Yes, exactly. Future is the time of which we are unaware.
So maybe it can be related in that way.
And what about C?
Is it because C's are limitless?
Maybe.
Okay, to find out whether our prediction is correct or not, let's look at the last stanza. Stanza 3. And what is the future? Happy one? A sea beneath a cloudless sun, a mighty, glorious, dazzling sea, stretching into infinity. Again, the poet is asking the child about his or her future, and child has given response using metaphor. So for the child, future is like a sea beneath a cloudless sun. Here, the child has indirectly compared his or her future with a cloud sea that is beneath the cloudless sun. It means the child looks at its future as a bright one. And if you look at the words like mighty, glorious, dazzling sea, stretching into infinity, here child has used lots of adjective to describe his or her future. That means the child consider his or her future to be bright, shining, full of opportunities. Task 3. And what you have to do is complete this web with the words that you feel suitable to describe your future. Or how do you look at your future? So I have done one for you. So for me, my future seems to be promising. Same way, you can use many more adjectives to describe as to how do you look at your future. So with the end of the last stanza, we have come to an end of our poem. Hope you all have enjoyed and understood the poem very well. And I hope you all are going to note down those two activities in your English portfolio. So see you again in our next class with yet another interesting topic. Till then, stay home, stay safe, and keep learning.